Oh, I didn't hear. You must be the one the Keeper told me about. Anethera.
I'm so sorry. I didn't ask your name. Unless... It's not rude to ask a human their name, is it? I'm Merrill, which you probably knew already. I'm rambling, sorry.
Why are you leaving the Dalish for Kirkwall?
I have to. Let's leave it at that for now, all right?
I get the feeling you're in trouble.
It's not like that. Not exactly, anyway. The Keeper and I have disagreements, but it will sort itself out in time.
Did you hear that strange noise?
Oh, I didn't hear anything.
You seem awfully nervous.
I've never met a human before. Dalish mothers frighten their children with stories about you, you know? Not you, personally, of course. I'm sure they don't have any tales about you. Or not scary ones, at least. Not that you're not notable enough to have a story. I'll just shut up now.
We didn't get a proper introduction.
I am... or was, I suppose. The first to keep a Marathari. I've studied the old ways for as long as I can remember. I know things. The lore of the Dalish that can help us get to the summit of Sandermort.
My name is Hawk. Glad to make your acquaintance, Merrill.
Thank you. I'm afraid I'm not very experienced with your kind. The Keeper said you came from Ferelden. I spent most of my life there. We only came north a few years ago. Have you been in the Free Marches long? Do you like it here?
Oh, I miss the cold. And the dirt. Kirkwall's not brown enough for me. But hey, no Darkspawn.
Ferelden wasn't that brown. The dirt and muck gave it character.
We should go.
Your task is for Asher Belinar. It's not wise to make her wait.
What do we have to do with the amulet?
It's a funeral of sorts. I'll perform it when we get to the mountaintop. Getting there is the tricky part. Our hunters haven't been able to reach the summit. Dark things are about.
I take it you've been expecting me to bring this amulet for some time.
The Keeper brought us here to wait for you. I don't know much more than that. I do know that you have Asher Belinar's amulet. And we must bring it to the altar on the mountaintop. Nothing more.
Do you know the witch who sent me here?
No. Not personally. My people tell stories of her, though. You're very lucky. Most people who meet Asher Belinar wind up in little pieces. Hanging from the trees.
Let's get this over with.
Get started.
The Keeper didn't mention you were a mage.
All Keepers know a bit of old magic. The stories tell us that all Elven once had the gift. But like so many things, it was lost. It's a Keeper's job to remember, to restore what we can.
Can't demons possess Dalish mages?
It can happen. And when it does, the clan must hunt and kill their own Keeper.
Does the Chantry know about the Dalish mages?
Oh, they know. Keeper Marathari told me that was one of the reasons we never camped too long in one place. They usually won't pursue us if we stay away from the cities and towns and keep moving.
And no one minds having to pick up and move over and over just to protect a few of you?
Why would they mind? Once we've picked over a hunting ground, there's no reason to stay. But my clan is now in more danger, having lost our Hala.
If you go to Kirkwall, you'll be an apostate in a city full of Templars.
I know. But if I don't go to Kirkwall, I'll be alone. A solitary elf is easy prey for anyone. In the city, I can get lost in the crowd.
I'm glad you decided to pitch in back there.
Oh, you're welcome. I wasn't sure I'd be much good. I've done a little fighting before, but it was always alone. I'll try not to hit anyone. On our side, I mean. I'm babbling again. Let's go.
The Keeper finally found someone to take you from here.
Yes.
Then finish your task quickly, human. We cannot be rid of this one too soon.
I'm sensing a story here.
I have made my choice. And I will save our clan, whatever you think.
What's going on here, Merrill?
Nothing. Just ignorance. We should go. I'm sorry. You're not really seeing the Dalish at their best. We're good people that look out for each other. Just not today, apparently.
Is there anything I can do to help?
It's kind of you to ask. I'm fine. Even if my people don't appreciate my efforts, I must see this through. Let's go. Ashabelanar isn't known for her patience.
I don't want to
It's about time.
Give you a hand with that.
The mountain is home to a lot of terrible things. A war long ago. Be on your guard. I can open the way forward. One moment.
Felt the veil shift. You called something here. Are you insane?
Yes, it was blood magic, but I know what I'm doing. The spirit helped us, didn't it?
Call it what it is. You summoned a demon.
Demons are just spirits, like honor or joy. It's not their fault they are what they are. Be careful up ahead. Restless things prowl the heights. In the days of Arlathan, the elders came here to sleep. Uthanara, the endless dream they called it, but they don't sleep peacefully anymore.
Let's finish this!
the altar, and I'll begin the rite.
Malana Sale Emma Ira Bella Saviranan Isalahamin Vinanhim Dofilas In Uthanera Narivas.
Here we are.
Andarana Tishyan Ashabalana.
One of the people. I see. So young and bright. Do you know who I am beyond that title?
I know only a little.
Then stand. The people bend their knee too quickly. So refreshing to see someone who keeps their end of a bargain. I half expected my amulet to end up in a merchant's pocket.
I agreed to deliver the amulet, though you could have told me you were inside it.
Just a piece. A small piece, but it was all I needed.
A bit of security, should the inevitable occur. And if I know my Morrigan, it already has.
Is that someone I should know?
She's a girl who thinks she knows what is what better than I or anyone. And why not? I raised her to be as she is. I cannot expect her to be less.
I'm not sure whether she's your daughter or your enemy.
Neither is she.
Why did you need me to bring you here?
Because I had an appointment to keep.
And because I did not want to be followed, you smuggled me here quite nicely.
I don't understand. Are you some kind of vision?
Must I be in only one place? Bodies are such limiting things.
I am but a fragment cast adrift from the whole, a bit of flotsam to cling to in the storm.
A fragment?
You do not need to understand, child. Know only that you may have saved my life, just as I once saved yours. An even trade, I think.
You have plans, I take it.
Destiny awaits us both, dear girl. We have much to do. Before I go, a word of advice.
We stand upon the precipice of change. The world fears the inevitable plummet into the abyss.
Watch for that moment, and when it comes, do not hesitate to leap.
It is only when you fall that you learn whether you can fly.
What should I do?
Do as I do. Become a dragon. You could never be a dragon. As for you, child, step carefully. No path is darker than when your eyes are shut.
Masaranus Ashabelinar.
Now the time has come for me to leave. You have my thanks and my sympathy.
Thank you. To arms!
Of apostates? Not even a little?
Sunshine, I'm a dwarf, in case you missed that detail.
Dwarves aren't completely immune to magic, you know.
No. I meant there are at least 30 people in this town who'd murder my family over trade deals. Who has time to worry about apostates with a merchant's guild breathing down your neck?
In that case, I see.
I can't do that.
That's not really my thing.
Here we go!
Masarana's child, your debt is paid in full. It isn't too late to change your mind, Dalen.
Dareth Shiral, Keeper.
I'm ready. Let's depart. Elganon. Is this really where the elves live?
Not the prettiest part of Kirkwall, but it doesn't have a view of the giant chains. Take what you can get.
I didn't think it would be so... I've never seen so many people in one place before. It seems so lonely.
You already know me. You'll make other friends soon enough.
Guy. Thank you. Thank you for everything. For all your help. Will you come visit me? Not now, of course. But maybe later. I could use a friend.
I think I can manage that.
Thank you. Oh, I'm thanking you too much, aren't I? I mean it, though.
Drinks later, if you'd like to join us.
Come on if I can. See you there.
Please, Sir Thrask. He won't go to the Circle willingly, but it's the only place.
Madam, we'll do our best to find your son, but I cannot guarantee his safety if he continues to resist Templar jurisdiction.
He's just a boy.
He's an apostate. I am sorry for your loss, Mistress. But I can offer your son mercy only if he turns himself in.
I'm trying to find him, but...
The Templars cannot tolerate apostates.
It sounds like your son is in trouble. Is there anything I can do?
You heard all of that and still you would help? An apostate? Oh, thank you. I am Ariane. My boy, Fainriel. He's all I have. All my family. When I learned he had magic, I could not bear to send him to the Circle. But his connection to the Fade, it gives him nightmares. Dreams of demons speaking in his mind. I would rather lose him to the Circle than to himself.
Did your son run away?
He learned I had contacted Sir Thrask. He felt I betrayed his trust. He thinks he can live free of the Circle, but I am afraid without proper training, he'll kill himself.
Those look like Dalish tattoos. Why do you live in the city?
I was born to the Dalish, but came to Kirkwall for a time and dallied with a human merchant, Vincenzo. When I found I was with child, neither Vincenzo nor my tribe wished the burden of an elf-blooded human infant. I raised Fainriel myself, here in the alienage.
Tell me the whole story.
I learned years ago that my son likely had magical talent, but we could not bear the thought of him locked in the gallows. So we hid. When the nightmares began, Fainriel still refused to contact the Circle. But I truly think they are the only people who might save his life.
What exactly do you need me to do?
Just find him, please. Bring him somewhere safe. I don't know where Fainriel is gone, but there are two places you might start your search. Sir Thrask has been looking for him. If you speak to him in the gallows, he'll be able to tell you what ground he's already covered. And Fainriel's father, Vincenzo, recently returned from Antiva. He's a merchant in the Lowtown Bazaar. Fainriel might have sought him out.
Tell me about this Templar.
I believe he's a good man.
He doesn't hate mages, but sees what it took me too long to realize. Even the best-intentioned mages are at the mercy of their sleeping minds. There are other Templars who are much less sympathetic.
You and Fainriel's father are not married?
Vincenzo had no desire for a wife or an elf-blooded child. I haven't seen him since the day I told him. I have written, though, to keep him informed about his child. Fainriel wanted to meet him.
I will not leave you fearful for a moment longer than necessary.
He ought to have his own life. Out from the shackles of the Circle. Everyone should.
My husband Wesley was a Templar. They're not all fanatics to be feared. Thank you. It has been a lonely time hiding. It's almost a relief to finally confront this openly.
Not yet.
I would like to know more about the guard, Aveline.
I don't think that's the job for you.
But it might help me not get caught. You
just... Never mind.
Hey there, lovely.
Everyone, please just step back.
My mother's in labor. The baby's come early. Can anyone help her?
I'll send word to the healer, but...
My son's hurt bad. Cart overturned on him in the blasted bone pit.
Everyone in your turn. I promise we have donations coming in. There will be food and medicine for all of you.
If you're seeking aid, leave your name with my girl. We serve everyone here. No one came from Ferelden without trouble. But I can't give priority to anyone who's already found work and lodging.
I hear you know where I can find a Ferelden Grey Warden.
Only Ferelden Grey Warden I've heard of slew the Archdemon to save us all. Fat lot they care here. We're out of the Blight's path now. Why would you need a Warden?
The healer was one of them once, wasn't he? A Warden?
Well, he's not now, and busy enough without answering fool questions about it.
Who are you protecting?
You see what our people face in Kirkwall. They have no jobs, no homes. Most can barely buy bread. This healer, he serves them without thought for coin. He's closed their wounds, delivered their children.
And yet he needs to hide.
He's a good man. I won't lose him to the Blighted Templars.
You mean he's a mage?
Would I stick my neck out for some purveyor of hensbane and leeches? He doesn't want to be locked in the gallows just for using the gifts the Maker gave him.
Your healer is in no danger from me.
If this mage is an apostate, the Templars will find him.
I suppose it isn't my secret to keep.
Anders has certainly been free enough with his services. Refugees in Darktown know to find the healer, look for the lit lantern. If you have need enough, Anders will be within.
I asked at 30 farms for work. Not one is hiring for Eldens. My wife died yesterday.
Hey, we heard you in there asking about the healer. We know what happens to mages in this town, and it ain't gonna happen to him.
Don't question me.
Let's show these folks a little Ferelden justice.
Be careful!
We break the law, I'm pretty sure. There are laws for almost everything. You're not a bad guard, are you?
No.
That's good. Is it because you're fond of Hawk? I kind of am.
How very nice for you. Keep it to yourself.
I'd rather keep it with her.
My, my. If it isn't Hawk. Good to see you again, Elegant. Lady Elegant, if you don't mind. I'm a married woman now. Last time we met, you were still working for that brutish thug, Mirren. Things have been going well since then?
It isn't always easy, but things are going well enough.
That's wonderful to hear. You may recall I supplied the Red Iron with potions. I'd be willing to extend you the same courtesy if you like. All I ask is you inform me of any interesting reagents you find. In exchange, I'll approach my contacts on your behalf. And of course you'll need the appropriate recipes, such as this one. Free, for old time's sake.
made this place a sanctum of healing and salvation. Why do you threaten it?
Strange occupation for a warden. Aren't you more about taint and death? Not healing and salvation.
Did the warden send you to bring me back? I'm not going. Those bastards made me get rid of my cat. Poor Sir Pouncelot. He hated the Deep Roads.
You had a cat named Sir Pouncelot in the Deep Roads.
It was a gift. A noble beast. Almost got ripped in half by a Genlock once. He swatted the bugger on the nose. Drew blood, too. The blighted warden said he made me too soft. I had to give him to a friend in Amaranthine.
So you came to Kirkwall just to escape the wardens?
You say that like it's a small thing. Yes. I'm here because there's no warden outpost, no darkspawn, and a whole host of refugees to blend in with. And some reasons of my own.
I've always heard that joining the wardens is for life.
That's only partly true. The hopelessly tainted by the darkspawn and plagued by nightmares about the archdemon parts don't go away. But it turns out if you hide well, you don't have to wear the uniform or go to the parties.
I'm part of an expedition into the Deep Roads. Any information you have could save people's lives.
I will die a happy man if I never think about the blighted Deep Roads again. You can't imagine what I've come through to get here. I'm not interested. Although, a favor for a favor. Does that sound like a fair deal? You help me, I'll help you.
Let's be more specific. I don't do anything involving children or animals.
I have a warden map of the depths in this area. But there's a price. I came to Kirkwall to aid a friend. A mage. A prisoner in the wretched gallows. The Templars learned of my plans to free him. Help me bring him safely past them, and you shall have your maps.
What do the Templars know of your plans?
I don't know. I had been exchanging notes with Carl through a maidservant in the gallows. Then the letters stopped coming.
You want to make your friend an apostate?
That's such a weighted term. Yes, Andraste said magic should serve man, not rule him. But I've yet to find a mage who wants to rule anything. It goes against no will of the Maker for mages to live as free as other men.
I doubt the Divine would agree with that.
The Divine is only a mouthpiece for the Chantry. The Maker does not speak through her. Never mind. I do not seek debate, only your aid.
Tell me about your friend.
His name is Carl Thekla. He was sent here from Ferelden, when Kirkwall Circle required new talent. His last letter said the Night Commander was turning the Circle into a prison. Mages are locked in their cells, refused appearances at court, made tranquil for the slightest crimes. I told him I would come.
Are these accusations true?
Ask any mage in Kirkwall. Over a dozen were made tranquil just this year. The more people you ask, the worse the rumors become.
How do you plan to break him out of the gallows?
I'm hoping it won't come to that. I sent Carl a message to meet me in the Chantry tonight. Maker willing, he'll be there, alone. But if there are Templars with him, I swear I'll free him from them, whatever the cost.
What do the Templars know of your plans?
I don't know. I had been then the letters stopped coming.
You've convinced me. What's your plan?
I welcome your aid. I have already sent word for Carl to meet me in the Chantry tonight. Join us there, and we'll ensure that no matter who is with him, we all walk away free.
Weldons. Free marchers.
Those shits that are paid off.
That's because you've spent too much time frolicking in the woods, Daisy. Dwarves don't frolic.
Dalish don't really frolic, either. Not in the woods, anyway.
You have sanctioned frolicking areas?
No, just not in the woods. The trees get jealous.
But you do frolic.
Of course we do. We wouldn't be elves otherwise.
I'd rescue the
Viscount. Why do you say that?
But the Winters are after him.
You were loathering with him, didn't you? And then not even your clan.
Humans don't have clans, Merrill.
Exactly. You came so far together, and you didn't even have a keeper to make you get along.
So your keeper tells you to stop kicking each other, or she'll turn the Aravel around?
Sometimes she also warns us to stop pulling hair.
Interesting. Gather round, all. We bring you
a... Greetings, my lady. You look like a woman who'd appreciate the finest rubies from Antiva gracing her lovely neck. I bring only the best northern merchandise to the free marches.
Actually, I'm more interested in your son.
My lady, I'm a bachelor. I've never met a woman of sufficient beauty and charm to tie Vincenzo down.
That's the best you can do with a guard staring you in the face.
Let us not ruin the day with such weighty thoughts. Perhaps I could show you my silks.
Fine. Hold your tongue. It's on your head if Feynrill dies.
The boy is a mage of elven blood. Do you wonder I fear for him? I do not wish to discuss my personal life. Let me know if you want to see my wares.
Younger and shorter, but not as serious.
So, it's a close resemblance, then?
Well, he tells stories. and you tell stories. Although none of his begin, "No shit, there I was."
I'll have to give him some better stories then.
It's no different than anything.
Are you the Templar who is pursuing the boy Fainreal?
I did not realize his name was known so widely. Perhaps you know Ariane from when she was with the Dalish.
We don't all know each other. There are a lot of clans, you know.
Are you a friend of his?
Have you met him? What is he like?
From his mother's description, he sounds much like any youngster we bring to the Circle. Frightened of his gift, resentful at losing his freedom, convinced he is the one exception to our laws. Hardly someone you would wish the power to murder people with his mind.
No young boy should have to face down demons alone.
It is surprising what sympathies mages evoke. I always expect people to be more wary of their powers than touched by their struggles. If we do not find Fainreal soon, it will not matter. Either he will be taken by the demons, or by less mystical predators. And I have said more than enough on the topic. This is a Templar matter, and we will be handling it.
Aveline, don't you think this matter concerns the whole city?
It does, and you Templars are spread thin to begin with.
True. Sadly, there are more mages fleeing than we can easily keep up with.
Then let the city guard do what we're good at. I can track the boy.
There is a Templar, former Templar, by the name of Samson. He left the Order due to philosophical differences. He has been known to help mages flee Kirkwall. If Fainreal went to him, Samson wouldn't tell me. He stays out of sight by day, but I've seen him at night, near the entrance to Darktown.
I was never given the opportunity for a harem.
Ah, welcome, my dear friend, to Sol's shop. My name is Solivitus. Please take a look around. My apologies in advance. Our shelves are a bit bare at the moment. Actually, if you're interested, I could use a bit of help to remedy that.
Remedy that? Potions shop. You, my good man, are priceless.
The pun wasn't intentional, although I may use that next time. It's been too dangerous to leave the city of late, and the substances I require for my creations are, of course, elsewhere. Perhaps you could find them. You'll be compensated for your time, have no fear. I'll also give you first pick of my new creations.
Make up a list of what you need, and I'll keep an eye out for you.
Perfect. A discount on everything in the shop, Sirrah. Thank you.